What's up, everybody? Welcome to A New English Bit. I'm Katya. In today's lesson, we're going to look at different ways to talk about advantages and disadvantages. On top of that, I'm gonna give you some synonyms to replace the words advantage and disadvantage. I think this vocabulary is especially useful for your speaking and writing exams, because more often than not, you're asked to discuss advantages and disadvantages of something. Are you ready to expand your vocabulary? If so, grab your vocabulary notebook and let's kick off. Obviously, you can say one advantage is, or one of the advantages is, or the advantage of something is. But let's look at some other more original ways to say the same. We could place some words before advantage and disadvantage. For instance, we could say the main advantage or the main disadvantage of something is. Or we can also say the most obvious or the key advantage or disadvantage of something. And now let's look at some examples. The first one, the main advantage of being self-employed is freedom. The second example, the most obvious advantage of shopping in the market is the high quality and freshness of food. And one more example, the key advantage of working from home is a better work-life balance. Number two, we could also say another, one further, or an additional advantage or disadvantage of something. And now, a few examples. The first one, another advantage of working for yourself is that you get to do what you love. Another example, one further advantage of shopping for food in the market is personalized service. And one more example, an additional advantage of working remotely is the drop in exhaust fumes emissions. We can also say that something is a huge, considerable, or major advantage or disadvantage. And now, some examples. The first one, social comparison is a huge disadvantage of social media. The second example, stress is a considerable disadvantage of our fast-paced world. And one more example here, the rainy weather is a major disadvantage of living in the UK. Now we're going to look at some synonyms for the word disadvantage. So instead of saying disadvantage all the time, we can say drawback. Another option is downside. We can also say handicap. And three more options, we can say a negative effect of something, or an objection to, or on the negative side. And now, a few examples. The first one, one drawback of living in a huge city like New York is noise pollution. The second example, the main downside of being famous is all the scrutiny you're exposed to. The third example, the main handicap of starting your own company is the initial investment. Number four, an objection to taking out a mortgage is paying interest. Two more examples. Number five, a negative effect of traveling by plane is the carbon footprint. And one more example, on the negative side, you have to be good at handling uncertainty when being your own boss. And now we're going to look at some synonyms to replace the word advantage. For example, we can say benefit, or a positive aspect, or a good point about something. We can also say plus point or bonus. And we can also use some expressions like on a positive note or on the positive side, on the plus side or on the upside. And now let's look at some examples. The first one, a benefit of mastering English is that you gain access to a lot of information. another example, a positive aspect of watching movies in their original version is that you can improve your English greatly. The third example, a good point about traveling is that you become more open-minded. Number four, a plus point of living abroad is that you're highly likely to grow as a person. Number five, another bonus is that you get to know new customs, traditions, and ways of life. Number six, the economy has taken a hit due to the pandemic. On a positive note, we slowed down our pace of life and learned not to take anything for granted. Number seven, on the negative side, we haven't traveled abroad for a while. On the positive side, we have got to know our surroundings better. Two more to go. Number eight, on the plus side, we have taken up new hobbies, activities, and projects. And last but not least, on the upside, now we appreciate little things much more. And before we finish, another super useful expression that you can use to talk about advantages and disadvantages of something is pros and cons. And it has to be used in plural. Pros with S at the end and cons. Let's look at two examples. The first one of the big pros of living in Valencia is its mild climate. And the last example, everything has its pros and cons. Hi, it's me from the future, and I just remembered two more expressions that I think can be handy for making contrasts. The first one is the flip side of the coin, or we can also say the other side of the coin. And we use this expression when we want to mention a different aspect of a situation. It can be both positive or negative. And now, two examples. The first one, the lockdown slowed down the spread of the pandemic, but on the flip side of the coin, the economy went downhill. We can use the preposition on the flip side of the coin. And one more example, I haven't traveled for a while, but it's worth looking at the flip side of the coin. I saved some money for a rainy day. The idiom to save or to keep money for a rainy day means to put some money aside for a future time of need. And the last expression for today, I promise, it's on the other end of the spectrum, or we can use the preposition at the other end of the spectrum, or we can also say at the opposite end of the spectrum, or on the opposite end of the spectrum. And we use this expression when we have two completely different things. It's like one thing is here and another one is here, and they are far apart. And now, one example. There are many people who prefer to live for today without thinking about the future. On the other end of the spectrum, others have a desperate need to keep on top of things and plan the future. To keep on top of things means to have everything under control. So guys, that's it for today. I really hope you enjoyed this English bit and found it useful. And I hope this vocabulary will stand you in good stead when taking your speaking and writing exams. If you found this lesson useful and learned something new, please don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up, to subscribe to my channel, and catch me on Instagram for more daily English. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!